What's going on, guys? Welcome back.
And we're now in Wales, and this is awesome. Hopefully, we're going to get some good weather, and it seems like the sun's come out for us. Currently on our way to the campsite. Real looking forward to this trip. Might be able to see Andy in the rear camera as we go around some of these bends. I'm walking this road. This is awesome.
The road.
On the road to Bower, and the weather's kind of closed in a little bit. It started getting a bit crap. But hopefully it eases off soon. Because this is not the best, of course.
There we go, there's the lake. Very nice. Look at that. Then we get to have a bit of fun.
It was dry for about fucking 5 seconds. Oh man.
Wales is such a beautiful place. Really is. Really, really is. Look at this. Coming out as well. This has got to be the best foam roll I've ever been on. Wow. Or an F-35 or something, I'm like...
So day one was pretty great. We got there and it was really, really nice weather in terms of like they would be flying in it. It wasn't like absolutely amazing, you know, clear skies and all that kind of stuff, but it was good enough for them to fly. And the important thing was we got there with ample time as well. Having set out late, we got there about 12, 1 o'clock, something like that. And then within a couple of hours, we literally had quite a few passes come through. So by the time 6 o'clock came around, we saw two Ospreys, two Texans, two Hawks, and then 1 o'clock in the morning, a Chinook came through and vibrated the campsite because it was that low. Absolutely awesome experience. I'd love to see something like that again. It was crazy good. I really enjoyed our trip. The one thing I didn't enjoy is the fact that I didn't actually go straight up the mountain like I wanted to. I decided, right, we've never been here before, we'll go and explore the local area, we'll have a walk around, and we saw some really nice stuff. There's some pictures on the screen of the area as well. It was absolutely stunning. But my main regret is the fact that we could have gone up the Mach Loop, like we could have literally gone up Cad East or Cad West, whichever one, and we could have seen those planes coming through. And that's my regret, is that we didn't do that and we went and explored the area. By the time we did go to have a look where the path went and everything like that, we decided we're going to wait till the day after, you know, to actually go and do the trip and like get up the mountain nice and early and hopefully be up there all day. Turned out to be one of the wettest days I've ever experienced. And unfortunately for Andy, who was with me, that meant that his tent leaked in water and just let him down completely. All his stuff got soaked, so we literally packed up when we got back to the tents. We threw everything on the bikes. He threw his tent in the bin and we came home. So unfortunately, that put a bit of a bitter taste in our mouths on the trip, but day one was amazing. The riding was amazing there and back, so I really can't complain. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this little tidbit talk, and let's jump back into the riding.
So here we are, leaving the campsite. Smithador, I think it's, I can't pronounce it to be completely honest, but we are leaving. Bikes are absolutely full of shit, and this path is a bit of a dirt track, so it's not the best.
Like, we had some really nice weather yesterday,
And today that weather has turned on us really. And we've ended up with nothing but rain. And I mean nothing but rain. It's literally not stopped from start to finish. We went for a walk this morning. Ended up all the way up there. And it ended up just being a complete and utter washout. Like, we got back and Andy's tent is piss wet through. So we've literally had to just call it a day and come home. It seems like the planes aren't flying anyway. Like, we've been here, obviously we've been here all day, and or half the day at least, and we've not seen anything yet. I mean, we might see something come through as we're riding home, but everyone's out here looking at the rain behind us and the weather forecast and everything. They don't reckon it's going to stop raining until 7 o'clock tonight. So the likelihood of anything coming through is quite sparse as it is. I'm going to go down a gear here. I mean, look at the scenery, but also you can't see shit. I'll be completely honest, guys, I just want to get home at this point, which is, it's not what you would normally hear from me. I want to be out, I want to be doing all sorts of stuff, but, you know, today has basically put that, for me and Andy, it's basically put it to bed. It's killed the day off. You know, knowing that he came back to a wet tent, it's not stopped raining, it's not forecast to stop raining. His tent was basically flooded. It basically made it so that anyone that, like, nobody else would stay in that scenario, would they? You know what I mean?
Loving this road though. In the middle of the road at all. I don't think anyone likes them on bikes. And they're always in the middle of the road, like always. TT. I'm kidding. Clearly it's not. Grid getting on the road. So don't like them.
Thank you.
So hopefully you guys have really enjoyed this video. I know it's been a long one, but hopefully you guys have enjoyed it. I know I did. It's been a really good trip that we had. It was a shame about the weather on the second day, but it is what it is. That happens, and we just got to deal with it better next time. So hope you guys have enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to like it and subscribe. Smash that thumbs up button. And stay subscribed for more content like this and some other stuff coming very soon. And I'll talk to you guys in the next one. Peace.